What is flow and why would it help you in your reinventing process? I'm going to let you know in this video. How's it going, reinventors? My name is Amelia Sims. This is Reinventing You, the channel where you can be inspired to take your own reinventing journey so that you can live a life of joy, fulfillment, and purpose. I post twice a week, and I just ask that if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up so that way I know to make more videos like this one. Have you ever heard of an athlete being in the zone? That is, they are in a flow state. What is flow and why would you want it to reinvent yourself? Now, flow is not a modern concept. It's not a postmodern concept. It's been around a while. Folks, psychologists and scientists back in the mid-1800s already can recognize a flow state, but it wasn't until a man named Mihav Csikszentmihalyi, he was the chair of the psychology department at the University of Chicago at the time, and he published a book in 1990 called Flow, The Psychology of Optimal Experience. And in this book, he talked about what flow is and why it was so significant. These days, this concept gets a lot more press time, I guess, and people like Maximilian Gotzler and Stephen Coulter have really talked about it. And I have a playlist that's right up here if you want to check more about flow. And this has gotten a lot of interest lately. People want to be in the zone. They want to be in the flow state. So how do you define flow? The brief definition of flow is that mental state of pure happiness where you immerse yourself in what you're doing and only focus on that one thing. And you don't let any other activity or anything else disturb you. In other words, if you love what you're doing and you focus on that thing and that thing alone, that means that you are in a flow state. Now, the flow state, from what I can understand, has at least 9 characteristics. Of course, it depends on who you're talking to. And I want to share with you those 9 characteristics so that you can recognize when you have been in a flow state or next when you will be in a flow state. When I was in the ministry, I know that I was in a flow state when I was writing or when I was preaching because I was so focused in that moment in what I was doing, and it was simply a time of pure joy and happiness. Now, as I said in some other videos, and you can see the one that I did recently right up here, I eventually lost that ability to have a flow state in those times, and you can see that in that video. But I think that we have all had a time where we've been in a flow state. A flow state has these 9 characteristics. And the first one is you have a clear goal. Whatever you're doing, you are doing that one thing. It is not a time for multitasking. You are focused on that one thing and have that clear goal in mind. The second thing is that you are completely absorbed in that activity. Like I said, you're not multitasking and you're not focusing on anything else. There's nothing that is going to break in on that activity or that project that you're working toward, that goal that you are working toward. The third thing about flow state is that you have no fear of failure. You are not thinking about what could go wrong. You are simply working on what you are working on. The fourth thing is a lack of self-consciousness. You are not thinking about yourself. You are not contemplating your other problems or difficulties in life or having this inner monologue. Of course, unless that's part of what your goal is, I guess if you are maybe writing like an autobiography, you might be some self-consciousness, but you are just there present in that moment. The fifth characteristic of a flow state is a distortion of time. That is, either time speeds up, you look up and all of a sudden you realize, oh my gosh, hours have passed, or you missed a meal or some other event, or time seems to slow down. Time does not flow like you normally think of time. The sixth characteristic of a flow state is that you have a balance of your skills and your challenges. In other words, you have certain abilities you're able to do, and yet you're still having some kind of a learning curve. You're still having a challenge out there that you're having to tackle even while you use your known abilities. The seventh characteristic of flow state is you don't question your own adequacy. You're not sitting there thinking, can I do this? You are going to do the project head on. The eighth characteristic of a flow state is that you forget all of the negative activities of life, or not a negative activity, the negative, you forget all of the negative aspects of life. You are not thinking about climate change or rotten politicians or the fact that you can't pay your bills. You are simply, whatever the project is, whatever the activities, you are simply present in that moment. The ninth characteristic of a flow state is that you have immediate feedback. In other words, what you are doing, the end result is your reward. You are not looking for somebody else to say, hey, you did a great job. What you do in that time period is reward itself. So what does flow or flow state have to do with reinventing yourself? That is making a major change in your life, whether it's in your relationships, your career, your health, or some other aspect of life. Well, I think first of all, if you get into a flow state, that is going to let you know what your passion is, what you love. And I talk a little bit about that in terms of finding your passion in this video up here on Ikigai, that is your passion, what you should be living for. And when you are in a flow state, that means you're doing something that you love, something that brings you great happiness. And so part of learning what flow is and what a flow state is can give you some clue as to if something is a passion of yours or something that you love or something that you probably should pursue more of. In fact, there's some talk that we should actually increase the flow in our life. You're actually more productive when you're in a flow state. And so that's what you need to focus on. And as I mentioned before, the playlist that I have about flow, and it's also down in the description, there are a couple of videos in that that also talk about increasing the flow or how you can increase the flow in your life. But if you already know when you have been in a flow state, if there's something you know that you do and you obviously, you know, the time's distorted, you have a clear goal, there's no fear involved, there's no inadequacy, there's no self-consciousness, all of those things, that means that you're in a flow state. And maybe that's something you need to pursue, especially if it's a hobby or a career or even a relationship, that you need to focus on that. Also, if a flow state focuses on happiness, if it brings happiness, then you're going to feel joy. If you are focused on something you love and the end result is simply, the reward is not the end result, the reward is actually doing whatever it is you're doing, then you're going to be fulfilled. So you've got a goal or a purpose, you have joy, you have fulfillment. That right there fits the definition of reinventing. And the same time that you want to reach a flow state and you want to know what your passion is and you want to replicate that so that you can have joy, fulfillment, and purpose in your life, there's also some danger about constantly being in a flow state. I'm going to go a little bit more in depth about what your brain is doing or what your body is doing when you are in a flow state and why that could be good or not in my next video. And once I've done the video, I will have a link below so that you can follow that. I don't know if you have been following my videos, and if you have, you may have noticed there's a quote behind me in each one of my videos, and it changes on occasion. I have a free PDF of 25 quotes. It is 25 pages. You can download that if you'll see that in the description below and in the comments. You can click on that and receive that free PDF. It's a collection of quotes about reinventing yourself. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you know that you've ever been in a flow state, please leave a comment below in the comment section and let me know that you know when you've been in a flow state. And if you really like this video and you want to see more of them, I have some more down in the description, but there's also some here on the screen, two of my most popular videos. This one is all about how to deal with nosy people. And this one up here is dealing with how less is more. Have a great one.